SME, working capital is an issue. So we have given a proposal to the government to tell them, look, up to 3 crores, tell them to register for GST, but zero rate will apply. They can take input tax credit, apply for refund. I hope you got the understanding. Apply for refund. Moment they cross 3 crores, they will be taxed automatically. They have to collect tax automatically because government has the control on their turnover. And it cannot be done only through GST. Two more changes has to be brought in. What are the two more changes? Today you go and speak to an MSME. You're all practicing SME practitioners. You know better the clients, actually. Go and interact with them. Their headache is working capital. Whether it is a large infrastructure company or an MSME today, is a working capital is an issue. This MSME, the problem is the collection. Recommendation is, I told the government in the representation that MSME Act has to be amended to tell the person who is not paying to the MSME within 30 days will be denied input tax credit. All input tax credit, not buying, anyway 0%. Hope you got the point. Anyway 0%, so no input tax credit will be there. But other parties they would have bought, that input tax credit will be denied. This will become a serious issue so that they will pay to the meager amount to the MSME. So their working capital is doubly ensured through input tax credit refund and two, the payment collection within 30 days, automatically MSME will be incentivized to be under the GST platform. This is the policy recommendation we have given. I'm sure we'll fight for it to be brought into the country. If this comes, it can turn the Indian economy into a prosperous economy because 93% of employment opportunity is not generated by big corporates, not big brands. It is my vegetable sellers, my lathe people who are operating, all these small units around the big factory. They are the game changer of my Indian economy. They are our people who has to be empowered under the economic angle. So the India is conscious about it. We are moved by the Western ideologies and things like that. We thought India is US and bringing all these policies, we need not have Harvards and Stanfords to bring policy in India. It was Kurian, the Amul founder, who said, the finance minister should come from the rural India. If that person comes from rural India, you know what to be done for inclusive India. Otherwise, you will exclude India because you think India is US or Europe. And European people come and rule, it is much more problem. So you need to understand the perspective of Indian economy. Indian economy is different from the other economies. It's a unique economy which requires inclusive development and last mile, integral humanism. The last mile people also should be empowered. That is the Mudra scheme of the government. So there are a lot of things which can be integrated. Thank you for this wonderful opportunity. I think the cost accountant is doing a wonderful job. Thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity.
Thank you, Satya. Nicely deliberated. And now hardly any time for me, so I will only say, I'll hand over the thing. Only the point which I'd like to definitely make is whether anti-profiteering clause, what government implements and whether it will be implemented or not, how it will be implemented, what is the statute backing for that, that debate, let it go to the policy level.
Yes, sir,
but
today morning, before this point, today morning, there is a news, the GST council secretary who has moved out to finance, he has said, the labor what you have put, I will not bring them to task. I'll bring them only the major distributors. The person who are selling in the street and shop are excluded. So that means to say, till the entire this thing, they cannot be booked. Only the maximum, the so-called distributor, they will be booked.
But I have a point for this, sir.
Yeah.
See, today in India, we have the HSN. That itself is wrong. Harmonized system of nomenclature. If costing institute can actually analyze the profile of all the products in India. You have 100 plus branches. Do a consultancy to the government on a pro bono basis, where you profile all the products in India with the business value chain and provide the recommendation of Indian products. We brought HSN code, which is a European methodology, and for example, what is that? Spectacles is called frames. Frame, and people think that frame is different. Okay, they have to search eyeglasses. They apply wrong rates. So you have to bring Indianized. And we have adopted HSN code. Why should we adopt HSN code when you have talents of professionals here in India? So HSN has to be customized. Government does not have time. If you could recommend some kind of and government doesn't know how many products are there in India. One, I'll tell you in Tamil, Mookkadala Association, that what is the gram in Hindi, I don't know. Problem is I'm in Tamil Nadu, I don't know Hindi, that's a problem. Channa fry. Channa without fry, no tax. If you fry, 18% tax. And this association people came in search of my home. I don't know where they got the number and things like that. They came to my home, morning time 6:30 I'm getting up, they're standing near my home. I'm saying, sir, this is the representation. What is the representation? Sir, without fry, no tax, sir. With the fry, 18%, sir. Can I sell? I will fry. Can I sell without telling the government it is not fried? This is the opinion they're asking me. I said, okay, you come to the finance minister's meeting, bring fried dal and the raw dal, and then keep before him and ask him. And then maybe he can give you a perspective. And for information, they presented, finance minister also accepted that there is a policy changes need to be brought in. And he took the representation also. And then groundnut candy and pizza, that went viral. Don't think the government does not like groundnut candy. Just because people said, finance minister does not like groundnut candy. That's the reason they brought 18%. Don't think that way. They did not go item wise. They took the Excel sheet, place the rate, try to reduce it, and more rate will be announced later when the government revises, you feel the government has done the duty. First you bring high rate, you all fear about the high rate, then the government reduces, you are happy now. If the government would have bought 200 products on the 1st July itself, you will not recognize the presence of the government. Now you recognize the presence of the government, so think that's how India functions. Sometimes this is how the policy making happens. Don't worry about it. I opened up all these things to make you aware. And beware how you can actually make a policy change is my question. And you have excellent team at the Central Council. And Ashok Nawalji book, even before the GST came, he was in the committee, I suppose. You released a book for GST for Make in India. That's a vision we have. And that book was excellent book. And that has to be updated in the present requirement. And if you could release that shortly, I think it would be a great opportunity. And maybe procedural book on anti-profiteering, the recommendation to the government. Instead of recommending to the government, make the book to sell first. So the people will understand. Release a 5 minutes YouTube video. Let it go and hit the finance minister's mobile. So somebody will show saying that this could be one of the things. Maybe it reaches his mind or may the policy makers and they will consider your points. This is the way we can impact the policy. Thank you for this wonderful opportunity again.
Sir, in morning, you might have come at time. Just a minute. This point was all well taken in my lecture itself. This was taken and dealt by me, and that is the reason I said the work of anti-profiteering, the work of all those things, our cost accounting profession has to become a facilitator for government, for the people, for the industry, trade and industry. And then only things will happen. I also said, I'll just, because ultimately all session has to end, and I have only 2 minutes now to talk. Though I have brought my detailed presentation, I could not.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
But only one point which I'd like to mention here, as rightly said by this, I reminded that in India, no elections are won on economic theory. Elections are only won on emotions. Decisions on because of election was taken not on economic grounds. And perhaps if 2020 vision one has to take as an institute, as a nation, for the re-engineering of the nation, then first we'll have to talk on how economic situation will change and will change the politics. That has to be first vision to the country, first vision to the all citizens. And basically, I say GST has given us the golden opportunity, and frequent changes has also given the golden opportunity that we have to ensure that our model of costing, model of management accounting is taken the main theme, and to see that anti-profiteering mechanism works, and if it works, then only inclusive growth will happen. Otherwise, we'll have the seminars, and every seminar there will be one topic, and same discussions will go on. Perhaps the time has come for the institute to go beyond the politics, internal, and work cohesively to showcase our profession. Yesterday, I will sum up by only saying 2 minutes, that we are talking about 1944, our company, 14 June 1944, company was formed, and in 59, we have taken the birth. From 59 till date, having 96 branches or so many branches were open, so many cost accountants in industry. But today, if you see, I am still fighting for my own visibility as a cost accountant. Why this could happen? Reason is, we could not showcase our strength. Had our 96 branches, all the chapters might have been associated with local municipal corporation, local state government, or local bodies.